Okay, good morning all of you. Okay, today's class I just picked up the set of numericals. Please do focus. You need not to write in your notebook. Just give maximum priority. Means don't write question answer everything. Only if you are solving, try to solve along with me. Or else make observation. I suggest you try to solve. Meanwhile, when I'm solving, make observation. Okay, fine. So this is the first question. We'll begin. Okay, this is about is asking find the electric flux crossing through the upper surface. So we'll give name for upper surface. A, B, C, D. So how much of flux passing through this one? Where is the point charge Q? Phase one, opposite phase. What else? Can be asked whether I'm not sure, like though these such formulas are not there. Till now in advance, they didn't ask anything where you should apply the solid angle for different surface. But I'm not very particular. They will ask, they will not ask. That blue color shaded strip, it has to be determined. I think this answer should not be this much. I'm very sure. We'll erase this answer. We'll see what we'll get further. Now, what is the method? How much of flux will pass through the cube? Shall we put Q by 2 epsilon naught? Because half of the flux will go on the other cube. If there's a line, if I keep a point charge Q here, so how much of flux will be there? So the lines of force. So we do, what is the flux? Just take help of the lines of force. It's a logical thinking. There's no concept, nothing. Fine. So if there's a cube, no? So half of the lines will pass through this particular cube. The remaining half will go for other side. So what is the flux passing through the cube? The first one. Q by 2 epsilon naught. In that, what happened? The surfaces, five faces are there. The four faces will share equally. The four faces will have the share that one. So what all this is equal to? Definitely, I think I should give number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Four times of the flux shared by (1, 2, 3, 4) + (2, 3, 7, 6). Will I agree? Why four times? Because the faces 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 6, 5, 5, 6, 7, 8, and flux linking 4, 3, 7, 8 should be the same because of symmetry. So what is our question that is asked? Flux through 1, 2, 3, 4. If you can calculate flux through 2, 3, 7, 6, this has to be determined. How to calculate 2, 3, 7, 6? I think if you can go back to the formula, I gave one formula. If you have, if this is the
2/6 epsilon, sir.
This will be 2L, no? Okay, this will be 2L, and this is 2L. Exactly from the center, this is an here is a Pontcharch Q is there. So I think we do have such one formula.
No need of formula. We can assume a cube. By combination of two cuboids, we can assume a cube. Each face will be cube by 6 epsilon.
If it is at center, no, it is not at center, no.
So we'll assume one more cuboid, sir, connecting that another the cuboid. And Q will become the center of that cube.
Only one cube or two cubes?
Sir, one cube is
cube. Already one is there, sir. We'll keep one more to the left of Q.
Okay, okay. The side length will become 2L, no? Oh, yes, okay, sir, fine, fine. Yeah, that'll be easier method. Yeah, that'll be easier method. I think I'll do one thing. Length how much will become?
Sir, this is a cuboid, sir, not a cube.
Not a cube, but we can make it a cube, no?
No, you wrote it's a cube, sir. Phi of cube.
No, here you won't. Okay, correction, I made it. Length should become 2L. Yeah. I think, yeah, this can be done. This will be L. This will be 2L. This will be 2L. So here is center, it will become, no? The flux linking 237. 2376. Yeah. This will be L. It will become at the midpoint, no? Q by 6 epsilon naught, we'll write it. Q by 12 it'll come, no?
Sir.
Q by 12, half of it.
Final answer will get Q by 12, sir.
Okay, this one. This will be Q by 6 epsilon naught. Okay, no. So finally, how much final answer?
Q by 12 epsilon naught.
Q by 12 epsilon naught. Okay, some logical questions can be asked, so just be careful. So this is especially Gauss law. You check the advanced paper nearly 9 times. Something is giving charge, is asking flux. It can be of any other thing. So final exam I'm talking about. So you should, I think in one of the year, no, they asked only one question that was on electrostatics. And that on Gauss law, finish all. In that year, student who knows only this particular thing, is well off. So Gauss law is the topmost priority for final advanced exam. Then you should come the preparation reverse. Okay, let's take the. He's asking you to compare some conditions. So I just drew the field lines. So there's a plate A, there's a plate B. So the plate B is slightly inclined. Then holding the upper plate at 5 volt relative to ground of the lower plate, what is it true about the falling location? So this plate D is earthed, the plate BD is earthed, plate AC is, upper plate is at 5 volt. Let me write that one. I'll magnify diagram. Yeah, try to see it now. So this is at plus 5 volt. We can do our thing. To the ground of lower plate. He's asking now how E bar will be directed. So what is the basic property of E bar? E bar should be always directed normal to the plate. It should originate and it should terminate normal to the plate. Fine, so this is at 5 volt, this is at 0 volt. So this will be the direction of the E bar. Especially you show it should be like this. the lines of force, you have to draw in such a way that it should originate and terminate normal to the plates. What will be the orientation, that one? Okay, after this. So looking at this, now what about the field? Is asking regarding the field at C and D. So the lines will be closer here, they'll be broader here. So look at the distance, no separation. So there's a point C, no, and there's a point D. So what about first will come for the field at A and B is asking. The A is here. Look at that one. VA, VB. VA, VB will compare that one. So definitely VA, what you expect VA? Oh. Now, what is the basic property of electric lines of force? What will be their direction? They'll be always directed from higher to lower potential. So VA should be greater than VB. You look at here, this part. And VC should be greater than VD. There's one basic property of this one. So this is the point A. This is the point B. This is C. This is D. So I agree with this. And can we compare even the field strength also? It's definitely what happened. The lines of force, what happened, will be more you can say congested. Or the spacing between lines. Here it will be less. I didn't show properly. Here it will be less. Here what happened? It will be more. So definitely the field strength at A will be greater than B. Will be non-uniform. Field strength at A will be greater than B. So can we pick up this option? VA greater than VB. VC greater than VD. The simplest idea, the E-bar will be directed always from higher to lower potential. That is enough. It need not whether straight line or curved irrespective of that. So what about the lines? Will not be, the field will not be uniform. There's the one thing. Field is non-uniform. Write it here. Now, what about charge distribution? Will it be uniform, non-uniform? Definitely should be non-uniform, the field distribution. So charge distribution should also be non-uniform. Non-uniform. Field line. Charge distribution. So something they'll take capacitor, one of the plate is slightly inclined, what conditions will occur? Okay, I'm testing you some basic idea. A semicircular disk of mass m and radius r with linear charge density lambda on its curved circumference is injured at its center and placed in a uniform electric field as shown in figure. The net electrostatic force acting on the ring, better say disk it is. That ring, no, the world should become disk. It's a injured at its center. So it is injured about its center. Here O is the inch. Let me draw a small diagram. The lines of force will be, and these dotted lines are the lines of force. It's a uniform electric field and it is injured about this particular point O. And there's a positive charge. So there's an electric field. Get into the idea now, what has to be done. So when it is slightly first net electrostatic force is acting. So shall we calculate what is the total lambda is the charge? What is the total charge on it? Total charge on it. Q should be equal to lambda into pi r. There's a total charge. And that net force, how it will act? It should act horizontal. So the total force acting on it should be Q into E. E is external field. Uniform electric field E. This one. So therefore, this will be lambda pi r into E. So there's a net force acting on that structure. It's a semicircular disk, but the charge is present only on what? On the semicircular part, that one. It's not a uniformly charged semicircular disk. It's in a disk, but charge is present only on the circumference. This is the condition. Now, after this, if the disk is slightly rotated above tau and release, find its time period of oscillation. Okay, let's, if it is slightly rotated. I'll bring the condition like this, no? Can we assume now a situation of like this? Let's calculate the torque. So this is the vertical. This was that horizontal, no? So now I give small displacement, let this be theta. Okay, do analyze. This is electrostatic field.
So net electric force, electrostatic force will be 2 lambda r, no, sir. Effective length we should take.
O side. Why? Nothing wrong, but can you give reason why?
So the y components get cancelled, no, sir. So the
let me finish off this part and I'll come here. No, this is the inch. Total charge, you do one thing.
I did some mistakes, sorry.
Okay, fine. Best thing is, shall I suggest you?
Direction I didn't.
Yeah, that one. You do one thing, you take one element here, symmetric element, calculate and integrate, you'll get same answer. Okay, now we'll get into the next part of our problem. I'll slightly rotate because it's asking time period of oscillation. So let me take help of this diagram. This will help us a lot. So I gave some small angular displacement phi. Then I want the torque. Will there be any torque acting? As a restoring torque will act. The angular displacement phi was given anticlockwise. A restoring torque will act in this direction about tau is set up here. So that torque will find out and we can get the time period of oscillations. So now how to get that torque here? So here, what is this? Where the charge is present? Charge is present where? Charge is present only on the circumference, no? So where the center of mass of the charge will be? The center of mass of charge will be located somewhere here. Call P something, I'll call it. So what is center of mass of the charge distribution? 2r by pi, shall I go for it? OP should be 2r by pi. So the total force, what we calculated, no? So that will Q into E, total charge is Q, that one. So that will act through this particular point. And it will set up a torque. So let me take this is R. So what is the angle between R bar and that one? It should be the phi only. It should be the phi. So therefore, what is the torque? Torque about O should be equal to F net into R sine phi. What is F net? Already we know, calculated lambda pi R E. What is small r? Small r should be 2R by pi into sine phi. So this should be equal to I naught alpha. So here what do we get? Pi get cancelled. So here lambda E R square 2 lambda E R square sine phi by I naught. If phi is very small and this is a retarding torque, it like root SHM. Omega equal to 2 lambda E R square I naught. Now the time period is given by 2 pi by omega. That I naught moment of inertia has to be calculated. What is I naught? What is I naught? Moment of inertia of semicircular disk here. So I think I naught should be equal to how much? MR square by 2 only. How much time period will be 2 pi r square. So this will be mr square height lambda e. R square will not be there. Yeah. Mr square by 2, no? Oh, yeah. Do you take outside? So M lambda E will come. So this will be the option. This is the time period. The work done by X-ray agent to rotate it through an angle alpha. I think we have a torque here, no? There's a torque. So work done by X-ray agent. I'll proceed like this. Work done by X-ray agent should be equal to torque into d theta. So what is that angle? Through an angle, alpha is telling 0 to alpha. D phi you substitute. Can you solve this? Just it's only integration. And then magnitude of electric field at O will be, I think you know, due to semicircular ring, what is the field strength at that point? So apply that concept and calculate that one. So here the troublesome is, I directly took, so this is very important, the way I'm writing this equation. This is the core idea of the problem. The whole charge, what happened with respect to charge distribution, I'll find out the center of charge distribution. The center of charge distribution will be, suppose say, the reason for that, the charge should possess mass. Of course, compared to mass of the disk, the charge present here will be negligible, mass of the charge. That's some assumption we made. So this charge will have a mass charge distribution. So it's where center of mass will be there. At that particular point, the whole charge, what happened, we can assume it to be located. And I'm proceeding further. It's a very rare few problems we do think, but naturally all our problems will be directly will go for it. Take the question, no? Read it. A soap bubble has uniformly distributed charge Q on its surface. Its energy is self-energy of charges and surface energy due to surface tension. In equilibrium, this energy is minimum. Surface at equilibrium, radius of the bubble is R and pressure inside is P. pressure outside is P naught. So let's assume a soap bubble. That particular material, charged material, is present only here. The remaining inside, there will be air. You check the advanced paper, especially I think they never missed asking question on surface tension. You check it. Even this year also, they've asked two questions, and one question was a little bit very, you can say, you have to put effort. So do make practice of that. There'll be one question, and every year what happens, they're asking something very different, which is not there in our book. That everything is a charge. So I think better students has to develop a skills to deal with surface tension, rather than known questions are not coming in surface tension, they're asking something new idea. Almost this trend is past 7 years, it's happening like this. Okay, this is about outside also air, P naught pressure. So force exerted by one off on the other off, you know, the electrostatics one. So how it is in equilibrium? So if you take one off of this, one off of this. So here on this side, electrostatic force will be acting. And pressure force will be acting like this, pi r square. And the force due to surface tension will act. Both inner as well as outer, I'm showing. Look at the arrows. The net, it will be force due to surface tension. And there's one off. So this is the, so now what you have to show, that this is like a one off of this bubble is what I'm displaying. I agree, no? Okay, now think, and unless it's in equilibrium. So first you write one equation. So here Fe plus delta P pi r square. Effective area pi r square should be equal to force due to surface tension at equilibrium. So what is Fe? Force exerted by one off on the other off. Q square. Total charge is Q, no? So I think I suggest you to directly remember that formula. I derived in notes. Check it once. Force exerted by one off on the other off. This is Fe. Delta P is what? P minus P naught pi r square equal to force due to surface tension. 2 into 2 pi r surface tension is telling S. Why 2? Because inner and outer surface are there. Both the surface, you can see this inner as well as outer surface in there. Okay, keep call this equation 1. Now, what is the total energy? The total energy of this should be equal to energy due to electrostatic field and energy due to surface tension. Energy due to this, KQ square by 2R. Energy due to surface tension, 2 into 4 pi R square into S. Will I agree this formula? What is the surface energy? Surface energy should be, surface tension formula should be surface energy per unit area. Can you remember this formula? So therefore, what is surface energy equal to? Surface tension into area, 4 pi r square. Why 2? Because 2 surface areas are there. Into this one. Okay, let's du by dr. We'll differentiate this equal to 0. So we'll get expression for the radius. Anybody value?
Q square by 128 pi square epsilon.
Option A. Option A, I'll take it. pi square epsilon naught s. So this is the radius, that one. So this value of r you substitute there and solve it, you'll get relation between p and p naught. You have to really see surface tension, no? So if you look at the grand test, no, the question which came, what happened, one of the question we are able to make a guess, the other question we could not make a guess. So I think definitely in the grand test papers, what you get, no, the surface tension. So please do make separate of that. 7 years it happened, almost surface tension is asking very typical questions. We try our level best from teacher to help you. So there's a basic idea. So I think this one is what you should remember. Force exerted by one off on the other off by a charged shell. So this you remember. So it'll be easy for you in exams. Okay, I'll go for next one. One more problem we'll try. Read the question. Here a charge 2q and here a charge q is placed. Okay, this is some sort of ring and everywhere soap film is there. So you can see like a, what is the soap film? Will be in the conical form. The soap film will be in the conical form. I can't. Okay, let me try. This is that ring and this is the soap film. Yeah, let's get into the problem now, the discussion. It's telling like it's an equilibrium. Inside air will be there. So this is what? Soap film. How the soap film will be in the form of conical. The slant face of the cone will be the soap film. And the point charge Q, this will be attached to the ring. That particular thing is not shown. This point charge Q will be attached to the ring. That is not being displayed here. Now it's everything is in equilibrium. So the ring is in equilibrium. So what are the forces that are acting on the ring? Electrostatic repulsive force and the force due to surface tension. The point charge plus Q, which is kept at the center, will be attached to the ring. Is not shown anything, that one. You are supposed to assume that one. So let's get into directly. Fe equal to force due to surface tension. Then what is Fe? Fe should be equal to Q, 2Q, 4 pi epsilon naught, H square. Force due to surface tension. So this is slant angle. Theta, let it be. Let this be phi. How the force due to surface tension should act tangential to surface. Everywhere it will act tangential to surface. So what is the force due to sufficient surface? Two A surface area will come. Inside air will be there, outside air will be there. So at an angle, I should take, so 2 into first 2 pi r surface tension. T is given, no? Surface tension T into, shall we write cos phi? Anybody, why that cos phi will come?
Component
of that particular thing. If this is a ring, the force due to surface tension will be like this. Where it will make an angle. In exams, I don't think so. You get any help even from the diagram also. You should be very good in making a guess of things. I'm making clear.
Sir, those forces should be directed inwards.
Okay, that will be. It should be inward, no? So. Okay, correct, no?
Why inward, sir? The outward is.
It is. I'll invert it.
They'll point towards the center. They should point towards the apex of the cone.
Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll make correction. They should point towards apex of cone, no? So this is the angle phi. So this should be the angle phi. This should be the angle phi. Okay, agree this. So solving this, we'll get that. What is cos phi? Cos phi, I think we can get easily. Cos phi should be equal to h by root of h square plus r square. H very much less than R, you're telling. Okay, and solve it. So you don't find, sir, like how Q will be attached to the ring. I think none of our business, sir. Better read question, get answer, and say goodbye to this question. That's all, no? In exam, we should not bother. Sir, how they'll attach Q. So most of some assumptions they do like that. Huh? You be careful. Let's get into next one. One off of the sphere carrying surface charge density. Sigma 1, other of sigma 2, the radius of this is capital R. Magnitude of force of alteration between hemispherical part carrying surface charge sigma 1 and the rest of hemispherical portion. It's a theoretical, practically conducting spherical shell and sigma 1, sigma 2. Okay, just let's assume that it's imagination. Let's not bother. It's not a disc, it's a spherical shell. It's asking force exerted by one off on the other off. So what is the basic idea now? This particular charge which is present here. Definitely the amount of charge present will be different on each hemispherical surface. Let's say thin shell. No, charge will not be there on inner surface. Charge will be there only on outer surface. So this charge which is present here, what it does, it will produce field on either way. Similarly, what can be E1, E2? E1 should be sigma 1 by 2 epsilon naught. Though it's a conductor, each face of conducting sheet will behave like a non-conducting sheet. We'll agree that golden statement. Each face of a conducting sheet will behave like a non-conducting sheet. So it's like a, though it's a conductor, but still what happened? It's like a non-conducting sheet only. So what is the field strength? Will be this much here. Now what will happen? The charge which is present. you assume shall we assume that charge present on this face will experience field due to this. So I'll assume a strip. Anywhere you can assume. Let me assume a strip of area ds. It's a circular strip. It's not like a arc. It's a strip. Then how the force, the net resultant force should be? Df. Should be equal to E1 into dQ2. dQ2 is what? Sigma 2 into ds. Further E1, sigma 1 by 2 epsilon naught. This is sigma 2 into ds. What should be the limit? Effective area 0 to pi r square, not 2 pi r square. So this will become sigma 1, sigma 2. Now you have many questions are there, sir. How come, if you look at the, how the field here will be, so it will be in the direction, no? This particular strip will expend force like this. This will expend force like this. The resultant force will be horizontal. That together we show effectively like this. Or else what you should do, you should assume a circular strip here. Then the force exerted, the force expended by the circular strip due to the field produced by the other hemispherical shell, integrate, solve it, you'll get the same answer. This is a shortcut method is what I'm just projecting it here. If sigma is same on either side, you'll get back the original answer Q square by 32 pi epsilon naught r square if you check it. Sigma 1, sigma 2, like this, not possible practically. Just it's a hypothetical. And I'll make here. Free charge like this, not possible, basically. There'll be redistribution of charge will occur. So it's a hypothetical situation. Let's come for next one. The charge is uniformly distributed with volume density alpha inside a sphere of radius A, where R is distance from center of sphere. Electric field strength vector E inside the sphere at a position vector R with respect to center of sphere can be expressed. I think there's a simple in mathematics based here. There's a uniformly charged sphere of radius A. So the field density is varying. It's asking electric field inside this. So let me assume a strip of radius r with dr. So what is the charge present in this? Let it be dq. Okay, fine. So now you proceed with the mathematics. So what is dq is equal to rho 4 pi r square dr. What is rho? Alpha root r 4 pi alpha 5 by 2 r to the power of 5 by 2 dr. The value of this is 1 by 2 will be 5 by 2 this one. Okay, now this is d cube present. So how much of, now is asking electric field at this particular point. So for that I'll apply the Gauss law. So the basic Gauss law will be E into 4 pi r square q in by epsilon naught. So this E into 4 pi r square, what is q in? Q in is a total charge. How to calculate the total charge in a sphere of this? I'll integrate 4 pi alpha r to power of 5 by 2 dr 0 to this one. I think if you look at the books, no, different types of charge distribution they're given, where rho equal to rho naught 1 minus 1 by r. Different types of this one, they'll ask you field potential. Instead also in gravitation we have done. It's a pure some mass based. So bring all the questions where the density is varying. Do one problem, that'll be enough. The same idea has to be continued. Okay, solving this, we'll get q in 4 pi alpha r to power of 7 by 2, 2 by 7. Okay, this expression for Qin, that value I'll substitute here. So this will be 4 pi alpha expression for this will be 8 pi by 7 3 by 2.
Two alpha by seven.
It is. I think should be 1 by 2 because R he has brought outside one. So R to the power of n is asking, no? So there should be 1 by 2. Some many problems are there. Do any one problem, that'll be sufficient because the density is varying, the idea, the method is same. If they ask you potential, what you should do? Dv equal to E bar dot dr, where this will be E into dr. Substitute, calculate first potential on the surface, then potential anywhere inside. Fine. Any of the related questions can come, just be careful. Potential on the surface, how to calculate? First, you should calculate the total charge. For total charge, put 0 to capital R. You get the charge. Then you know, if you know total charge, then you can get the potential. Potential on the surface will be Q by 4 pi epsilon naught into A. So what is Q? Q should be 4 pi alpha 8 pi alpha 7 a to power of 7 by 2. Substitute that, you'll get the potential on surface, then you'll get potential anywhere inside. Very important for advanced exams, may not be mains. Let's come some logical question. I think first in the second diagram, this is what he has shown. Just I brought the second set of diagrams. Huh? In the second diagram at P, what happened? You should calculate the E bar and the potential. So what elemental structure you are going to assume? What elemental structure we should assume here? So I think it's a problem is based on dimension analysis. Please, you have to be very logical here. This question, So don't assume any elemental structure, I'll find out. I don't think so. We have do have a field due to square plate or rectangular plate, if this is sigma. So what is the field strength? Somewhere here. Think logically, nothing bigger. So what is this? Everything, this is a charge. Charged, thin charged plate, non-conducting charged plate. Finite, not infinite. For finite, infinite, we know it. Have a clarity, that's all. For the last sheet, we know field, sigma by 2 epsilon naught. But for finite sheet, S, we don't have a formula. Agreed? If you want to, you can derive it, but surface integral will come. The integration in area integral should come. What all our syllabus is based on what? Our syllabus is based only on the line integral. You have to take help of surface integral, you can work out. If you look at some higher engineering books, no, they are shown that one. You have to go for surface integral. So need not to bother. Don't go for that extent. It's no use. So what you can say is it's possible by mathematics, but at our level, not possible. Using surface integral, you can calculate. Okay, leave that one. So no question of now, assuming elemental structure. So what to do? So dimension analysis. Field at P can be determined by surface integral. Let's go get into. So what you should do, the method is you assume one strip here, calculate the field at that point, then integrate, you'll get the answer. It'll be very lengthy. Don't explore all such things. No use for us. No. So what is the next alternative left over? The dimension analysis. We know expression for electric field is equal to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught X square. What is the Q? There's a solid object, no? Q should be equal to rho into some volume. I'll write some alpha x q. So therefore this, if I substitute alpha x q 4 pi epsilon naught x square. So E shall be, I'll write some E. Shall we put E proportional to x? So a truncated cone is what removed here now. So earlier, what is the field? Field will be E naught. The field here will be E naught. The new field here will be, say, E. Now that E has to be determined. That's what our question. I'll put by red color arrows. This can be asked. So you can't say logical thinking questions should not be asked. Now the E is proportional to X, or E naught will be proportional to H. Similarly, this E should be proportional to E dash should be proportional to E. If I draw a smaller pyramid, I need smaller pyramid. I'll draw it. Pyramid. Yeah. And there's a pyramid of height h, small h, truncated one. The truncated one, the remote portion. So what should be the field E dash? E dash should be proportional to h. This E naught is proportional to this one nearby this, I'll write it. Now what you are removing now, if you take this negative density and if you keep it here, if these two get subtracted, what do we get? We get the field due to the remaining part of this one, the E. E dash is due to what? So I should subtract here, no? So now what is this proportionality? Say some values, KH. So what is the total E, the net field? E naught minus E dash. So dividing these two, E dash is equal to E naught minus KH. What is K? E naught by H. So how much of H? H is equal to small h by 2 is telling. E naught by 2. Based on dimension analysis. Problem based on we do have plenty of numericals which are based on dimension analysis only, something structured. Other than ring disk, if you get square plates, pyramid, square plate, rectangle plate, no, better to use dimension analysis only. Got it? Now, similarly, potential. Okay, let's come for potential formula. Potential equal to Q 4 pi epsilon naught x. Q will be, say, some rho A x cube 4 pi epsilon naught x. So, therefore, potential is proportional to what? X square. Now looking at the first diagram, so what is potential? Potential should be equal to K, this is say some beta H square. Then V dash should be equal to beta H square. Then the net potential will be V should be equal to V naught minus V dash. V naught, V dash is what? Beta H square. Beta is V naught by H square, H square. Okay, this one. Let's come for some typical problems. Read the question. Revision of electrostatics, very easy. That's what I feel. Revision of electrostatics will be much easier. Find its kinetic energy when it reaches point B. Constraint to move along this field line. Okay, don't bother who will move, how it will move. That is not our point. We have to just solve and get the answer. Constraint to move himself is telling. Okay, let's leave it. Because as such, if you just leave charge particle, will it move along lines of force? The answer is no. That's why the word constraint has to be brought it here. Will I agree? Why that constraint word has to be brought? If you set a test charge, if you release a test charge in an electrostatic field, it need not move along the lines of force. So, sir, what is the meaning of that? Suppose if this is the field, if you release a test charge here, the force will act here, F1. After some time, what will happen when it arrives here? Let's assume that one, it arrives here. It will have velocity V1 like this, and the force will be like this. How do it will move now? Now it will move in this direction. So no question of it following the lines of force, no. But if the lines of force is straight line, if you release the test charge, definitely it will move along the lines of force. So look at the lines of force. It's not a straight line, no, curved one. So it will not move along lines of force, but it is made to constraint to move along that one. So I directly come forward. So everywhere out the force will act tangential to the path. Dr, and this F, no? So everywhere the force and this one. So work done, dw equal to f into dr. So this equal to q into dr. So what is the path length? Pi r. That's the first part. Then how to get the kinetic energy? So kinetic energy at A, work done should be equal to kinetic energy. It is released from rest. Work done QE pi r equal to m VB square. Exit this. Okay, now after this, it's asking find the acceleration of particle when it is at midpoint of the path from AB. So where the midpoint? Midpoint will come here. So here the charge particle, what are the forces? Electrostatic force and the normal force, no, centripetal force, better you call. Why do that centripetal force? Look at it is moving in curved path, no? It is asking only acceleration. Okay, let me write A normal, A tangential. So what is A tangential? A tangential should be definitely equal to electrostatic force by mass. So QE by M, this is electrostatic. What about A normal? A normal should be the velocity at that instant. V square by R. Do we know velocity there? Do we know velocity at that point? Again, I'll use the same formula. Velocity, kinetic energy, mv square by 2 should be equal to qe integral of, this is pi r by 2. So what is v square is equal to? V square by r is needed, no? So this should be equal to qe pi by m. This will be the normal acceleration. So what is the total resultant acceleration? A normal square plus A tangential square. So definitely some agent is needed. As that agent is needed, that agent will not do work. It will exert a force. You will see that it will move in a curved path. The electrostatic force is not responsible for in curved path. There's some external agent. And how that external agent will exert force normally. So therefore, we are not bringing work done by him. Carefully look at this point charge Q and the plate. First, read the question. So we have a plate. And this plate, it is earthed. Let me locate a point charge. No. So what is the point charge, lines of force, how it will be? The lines of force will be radially outward, no? It's isolated, but this is a conductor, metal plate, there's a conductor. Huh? And how the lines of force should terminate, or the E bar, it will induce a charge. So negative charge will be induced here. Negative charge will be induced on this plate, and the positive charge which is induced will flow to the earth. Okay, no, this one. So now how the lines of force. So lines of force should be here, you show like this. They should not intersect. I'll show only few. This will be the lines of force. Okay, the induced charge. Okay, let's come for the A and B. B is here, no? Yeah, we'll take this A and B. So he's asking, no? At which point is the electric field stronger? At which point is the potential higher? How to decide that? Once again, at A, definitely. So if you look at this particular thing here, look at this distance spacing. So for our calculation purpose, I'll just show like this. So this distance, you look at Y1, Y2. Y2 will be greater than Y1. Spacing between the lines. So therefore, EA must be greater than EB. Then the lines of force should be always directed from I to lower potential. So VA greater than VB. So I think here we should be very good in what, like drawing lines of force. Unless if you don't draw lines of force, not possible. Can you go for any mathematics? Very difficult, no? Because look at the field. Will it be uniform or non-uniform on the plate? The charge distribution on the plate will be uniform or non-uniform? Will be non-uniform. So mathematics will not help. Instead, what happened? The lines of force, what you draw will help us to analyze. What happens positive charge? Positive charge will flow to the earth. Only the negative charge you have to show on the plate. I find the work done by X-ray agent in changing the configuration. Think on this, I'll have water. We are discussing now the interaction potential energy. We'll give some name for the individual diagrams. So this will be 2, 3, 4. So what is the first diagram? The interaction potential energy, U. There's a first diagram, there's a second diagram. So what are the interactions? U1, 2. U13 plus U14, U23, U24. Six interactions will be there already, you know. U12 will be minus KQ square A. U13, KQ square by root 2A. U14, KQ square. To explain, I'm writing in exam directly, you should cancel out things. U23 will be KQ square A. U24, u3 4 will be k q square by, I think all will cancel, you know, this will be zero. Finish over, come for the second part. It's like a rhombus. Little bit, we have to be careful. Let's see that how things will come here in this case. It's telling rhombus, no? Let's get into the geometry of this. So this will be the diagonal, we'll draw it for our reference. This angle is 120. So this angle (60, 90), so therefore this should be 30. This should be 60, 30, this is 90. The similar situation here also, 60. Like this, we can get the angles. You can draw a diagonal. Oh, no, so this is the Q minus Q, Q. So this will be 5, we'll give number 5, 6, 7, 8. The same interaction, so the side length. Only thing is the diagonals is what? The diagonal length has to be calculated. Length 5, 7, how much will be length 5, 7?
2, 3a.
Root 3a, yeah. Then similarly length 6, 8. Equal to a only, yeah. I just made to explain that angles, I made other thing, what happened, directly go for the diagonal length in the rhombus, this particular thing. So now write down the interaction in the second situation. U5, 6, U5, 7, U5, 8 plus U6, 7, U6, 8, U7, 8. 6, 7, 6, 8, 7, 8. U5, 6 will be k q square by a, 5, 7 k q square by root 3, 5, 8 k q square by a, 6, 7 minus k q square by a, 6, 8 7, 8 will be work done by extra agent should be always final minus initial. And this is also a very popular way of asking questions. Check the answer. Answer should come this much. Yes, sir. Yeah. Read the question. Two parts are there. The first part, the separation is infinity. The two spheres are far apart. Okay, first part we'll discuss. They're separated to infinity. Okay, no, so this will be the diagram separated to infinity, and here LMOA charge Q from the center of this shell, I'll move it. From the center of shell, a point charge Q is moved slowly from center of shell through a small hole in it to the center of the ball. Find the work done by action agent. What we should do, we should calculate the potential at the center of the shell. So what is the potential at the center of shell? I'll write this point as 1, this point as 2. So first we'll calculate what are potentials at that point. So V1 is equal to, this should be equal to potential KQ by R. Because what is the potential on the surface? There should be the potential everywhere inside the shell. And what about potential at this point? 3KQ by 2R. It's a uniformly charged sphere. So I'll make the charge to pass through a small hole. Now what is work done by external agent in moving a charge from 1 to 2 should be equal to Q into, we'll agree this formula. Work done by extra agent should be equal to work done extra agent in moving a point charge through from 1 to 2 should be equal to V2 minus V1. By electrostatic phi will be V1 to V2. We'll agree this. There's a formula I think at many places we used. This one. Okay, let's come forward. Potential at that point, 3KQ 2R. Potential at that point, KQ by R. So this should be equal to KQ by 2R. This is the first case. In second case, what it's doing is just telling that the separation between them we'll take the next situation. They are separated by 4R. The centers are separated by 4R. I think now you have to be careful. What is the potential at point 1? Due to shell, how much it should be? KQ by R. Due to this, it will be KQ by 4R. Okay, so this will be phi KQ by 4R. Similarly, potential at the center of the ball. Due to ball, it will be 3KQ by 2R plus KQ by 4R. 7KQ by, check once. Yeah. Yeah, this will be. Now work done by extra agent. In this case, we'll write it. Q into work done by extra agent in moving from point 1 to 2 should be equal to Q V2 minus V1. 7KQ by 4R.
Same thing, sir. K cube by
K cube by 2 R. Somewhere they may ask in exam, please be careful. Instead of numerical, no, they'll ask this as more than one option. If we move from year to year, work done, then separated, as if it changes the separation. That this information is very important. I think anything we should work out and predict, no, rather than making guess. If I don't give like a numerical no, we may go for options like will be different. The answer in B will be different. But if you take example line, verify it, that'll be better. Now there's one more small concept I'm bringing. A conducting sphere of radius r carries a charge q. It is enclosed by another concentric spherical shell of radius 2r. Is asking something work done. Say is asking very carefully some condition. So how you manage that? This is of radius r. So there's a charge q on it. And what it does, it will induce a charge. And it will further induce a now what will be the all these charges? Should be same, no? Because what is the net charge of outer shell is zero. So therefore minus q plus q will be there. So here minus q. This will be minus q plus q. This what happens. So shall we'll give name shell A, shall be like that. It'll be easy for us to write equation. So what was the shall be was neutral, no? So net charge of that should be. So now what happened? The action agent is going to transfer this charge infinitesimally. What do you mean by infinitesimal? Small amount of charge from shell A, I'll take it. I'll put on shell B. So finally, what will happen? The whole charge will come and settle on the shell B. How to get that work done? So
agent self energy.
That is what the total energy of the system is what you have to compare. You can't do any integration here, please. You have to take up of the energy. I'll take it out all these charges because the whole charge will be transferred. Oh. Now get into this one. See, again, you can't just blindly I'll calculate the energy, that one. Even in calculating energy also, you should think how to save that time. So it's all about, what about the field outside the shell? Will it change or will remain same in both the diagrams? What about the field outside the shell? Will remain same. So the field from the surface of shell B to infinity will not change, no? In both the cases. There's a rough diagram I'm showing it. There won't be change in the field strength. So whatever the energy distributed from the surface of the shell to the infinity, from the surface of shell B to infinity, that will not change. So what energy has changed here now? The energy between the shells. So therefore, what is the work done by exchange and the difference in that energy? The electrostatic field energy that is present between the region between the shells, that has to be changed here. This energy So this I'll call EB. This field I'll call EA. Let's calculate expression for EA. EA should be equal to KQ by R square, where R will be less than 2R greater than R. Will I agree this? So can we calculate the energy present in that region, spherical region? So DU should be equal to half epsilon naught EA squared 4 pi R squared dr. What is this formula? Energy density formula. Okay, for your benefit, I'll write one more step. Elemental volume. So I'm assuming a shell, a thin shell of radius r dr. Small diagram will make it. This is shell A, shell B, R, this radius 2R, this radius is R. So the amount of energy present in this B, DU. So this you substitute and integrate from capital R to 2R, then you get that energy. That energy is what the exchange has to do work. I'll proceed next year of 4 pi epsilon naught by 2 R square. EA is how much? KQ by R square whole square into dr. Next step will be 1K will get eliminated. KQ square by 2 R to 2R. KQ square by 4R is what? I'm writing this energy. So tell me like a, what will happen to this energy? Will it increase or decrease?
Decrease,
no? So therefore work done by exchange agent should be positive or negative? Should be negative. Final energy minus initial. Final energy, what happened? There'll be energy outside plus this energy minus initial energy will be the final energy will be only energy outside. So there's everything. What will happen if I substitute here? I'll end up with this one. What is U final? U final will be some energy outside. It's called U naught. Here U naught plus this U. U is this much of energy present. Or you write U naught. I'll write one more step. It'll be easier. So some energy aspect, some situations will going to help us a lot. If you join a wire, instead of transferring, if you join a wire, that is the charge from inner shell will go to outer shell. In that case, you calculate. There'll be some heat will also be lost. No? So they may test you with all these things. Huh? Just be careful. joined by a wire we did in class. So there's another method just I picked up. Read the question.
Same question.
There's some three dipoles are there. He's asking what can be the at the centroid of triangle, what will be the electric field and the potential. Let's come for this one. This is a centroid. At this particular point, we have to calculate the field line, the potential. I'm very sure potential should be zero. Will I agree? Because on the bisector, if there's a dipole, so what would be the potential on the bisector? Should be zero, no? Potential at all points on bisector must be zero. Potential at all points must be zero. So this is a 1, 2, 3. So definitely potential at point C must be zero. Due to individual dipole, don't take again superposition. Due to individual dipole, it should be zero. At C, potential at C equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Due to individual dipole, it is zero. No, what about the field? How the field on the bisector should be opposite to the dipole, no? On the bisector, how the electric field will be directed opposite to the dipole moment. And look at all this. What is the angle made by P bar with each other? 120 degrees. So the resultant E bar also there will make angle between them will be 120. E bar should be, this is E bar.
Sir, the three dipoles are not symmetric.
Which one?
The three dipoles are not symmetric. Like each of them will not have an angle of 120 degrees between them. Because if you take the top one and the left one, the arrows are pointing in one direction. And if you take the top one and the bottom two ones, they are in like continuous way.
Oh. Potential be zero. There won't be problem. So let's calculate the field. Oh, I think the arrow, I'll change it. This arrow should be here. Now check it.
Now it is symmetric.
No symmetry will come. No, okay, we'll see this. No, E bar will be there. Okay, let's make a guess of the diagram. So at C it will be E3 bar like this. E1 bar. E2 bar. What can be this angle, sir? Anybody? This angle 60. No. This angle will be 60. Yeah. No. Okay. Fine. No, I think it'll cancel out. Net field at C will be simple idea-based problem. Today I just picked up simple idea-based problems. So rather than lengthy integrations, some simple idea-based problems are there. So you be careful in exam. So nobody, I think, especially final advanced exams, they don't want to go for higher mathematics, means where you have to solve so many equations and getting answer. Definitely one dipole, okay, some math will come. When two, three dipoles will come, so definitely the concept will be something very logical one. Okay, there's one more dipole right there. This problem will finish off. Calculate LT of a system comprising charge Q distributed uniformly on a semicircular arc or of radius R and a point charge minus Q kept at center. I do have here. So there's a semicircular arc. A point charge minus Q kept, and remaining this positive charge will be distributed. So will it make a dipole? Yes, the system will make a dipole. Radius is R. So we'll assume a strip. Here one strip. So let this be theta, let this be dq. Here minus q is there. You this minus q, what happened? You assume minus dq like that. So let this be r. So this will become one dipole system. dp dash. So what is the net dipole moment? 2 dp dash cos theta. Dp dash, what we can write it as? R into dq. This should be into cos theta. So 2r dq, what we can write? Lambda into ds, arc length. Two lambda r ds, what we can write? R d theta. So 2 lambda r square cos theta d theta. This is the net dipole moment. What can be the limit? 0 to pi by 2. 2 lambda r square. This will be cos theta sin theta 0 to pi by 2. So 2 lambda r square. What is lambda? Lambda we define q by pi r. Which one? Yeah, this will be 2q r by pi. What they do? This, if it is kept in electric field, work done. I brought one problem. That was only. Now dipole, I can rotate. I can ask you something problems related to dipole. If there's an urgent electric field, this point charge q will be slightly fixed, will be fixed here. So this entire system I can rotate. Then I'll ask you find the time period of oscillation. Any of the application questions will come. Dipole means need not be always a point to point charges. It can be a charged body and also a point charge. Together they can make a dipole system. And how it will be directed? Towards left minus I cap, because it's a dipole moment, no? The net dipole will be directed towards left. This such a system now can be taken hand, can be put in an electric, in a uniform electric field. Then they may ask you some work done to rotate this. Then time period of oscillations can be brought it here. Okay, we'll take one more last. This is some. There's an infinite non-conducting sheet of charge. So for a large sheet, what is this assumption? So this will be a large sheet. Everywhere charge is present. Then what is the field strength? The field strength is given by E1 equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. That's what we know. For this, if you add up a circular disk, because that hole is made, no? That hole is made. Portion of radius r. Okay, please read question. I'm just. A circular portion of radius r very much less than x centered at O is removed from the sheet. Now the field at point P becomes E naught minus delta E. Find that E is asking. So here definitely due to this, how much it will be? E2. So when you take the superposition, now this will be of negative charge density. Shall we put it of negative charge density? When you take superposition of that, what happened? We'll get a field here. So what is the field due to charged disk? I think if you know that formula, you can manage. Otherwise, you can't derive in exam. Definitely a need arises to remember the field due to standard objects. Even for anybody, but he has put some condition. What is that? R very much less than X. What does it mean? If he has not said this, okay, you could have done, but you say the R very much less than X is telling. So what shall I do with that?
Approximation.
This is like a point charger, not a disk. Treat disk as point charge. So what is the charge? Point charge q, you write. So what is q equal to? Sigma into pi r square. That r will come into picture like this. So what is the electrostatic field at that particular point? E2 should be equal to q by 4 pi. So what is Q? Q should be sigma pi r square 4 pi epsilon naught x square. Pi get cancelled. Sigma r square by 4 epsilon naught. I think this is what, sorry, this is what.
E2 should be towards left now, sir.
I'll change. So let me bring the question symbols. This should be towards left. This is delta E. Be careful that r less than x is something, because of that I'm writing. Otherwise, what I should do, I should use the circular disk one. And straight away, look at the mathematical conditions, what is going to put it here. I think tomorrow we'll do. This will take more time. These things we'll pick up these problems tomorrow. Okay, you have to recollect all the ideas and work out different types of numerical. There's only alternative method available in revision. And electrostatics is a topic where you have to go through the different varieties of problem. Please plan properly. Huh? Okay, thank you all of you. Take care, bye, see you. Counseling at 2 to 3, what happened? You send doubts in WhatsApp. Huh? Any doubts what you have, you can upload in WhatsApp. Huh? Directly I'll post in group, because searching your numbers, name, very problematic. What all you have doubts, no, the answers I'll directly post in your WhatsApp group. Okay, bye all of you.